Okay, so can you just name a few which is innovation and which is creativity? Out of those 25, at least 2-3 innovations, 2-3 creativities. As per definition, one which is just an idea to feel good is creativity. Something which actually is going to add value is innovation. You understand that, right? What are, which was there, any examples which was innovation and any example which was creativity? Sorry? Okay, that is what? Innovation or? Innovation. Good. What else?
Data is movie data. It's innovation.
Okay, that is innovation. Yes, next.
And that's the trash machine which
uses
out the ticket.
Yes, that's what she said. That's what she said, yeah. So the trash machine which uses out the tickets. The best one, I think. The bench. The bench is really creative, right? Of course, you need to clean it at least once in 0.9, but you don't need to clean it every time. Did you get to know the bench thing? Right? You rotate it and sit in the clean air area. Good. That is what? Get your thing. Three more points. Guys!
Steps.
Steps. What did Google? Google is very innovative in having people engagements. Right? They love their employees a lot. Right? I wish you get into those companies where they love people. That is very rare though. They have workspaces, not like so formal. Go sit in the posh tight buttons and all this sit. Go to the cafe, you need to have coffee and come back and sit. You are not allowed to take the coffee cup. My Accenture is like that. Etc. Right? Google has got beanbags spread across. Everywhere connectivity is there. You go, sit wherever you want, start working on it. If you want to come from third floor to second floor, you take a slide. You don't need to go to the lift, press second button, come down and again go to the north. You can just slide on there. The slides, as we have in the children's park, they are the fiber chair and all those things. You go sit there. If at all you want to be in silos, you want to think something. You have a cup and a coconut kind of a shape, one bean making there. You just go sit there inside, lock yourself inside and do something. Things like that. So they pamper you like anything. Right? Just to make sure that you feel at ease, you feel relaxed, you feel contented and give out ideas. They are just beyond ideas. They are just beyond creativity. There are many companies like that. Right? So the slide was one of those. Those guys who are lazy to climb down, right? Those guys who are lazy to write, they can use these things. Alright? So yeah. Take it fast and then close it. There are three levels. You are talking about the third level, right? There are three levels of being innovation or giving the innovation for the industry. One, it talks about optimizing the existing product. Is this visible for the last? Right. Optimize, that means your eyes are good. Optimizing because I can't. Optimizing existing products, service to the customers. So it is like enhancing the user experience. How do you do it? Any example? Things are already existing there. You enhance a user experience and that's it. What is that? Any example? You also can give an example.
Packaging.
Sorry?
Packaging.
Or I remember, I'm not sure if you were born in those days also, I'm not sure. We used to have those Colgate or Vicco versus anything kind of paste. That tubes were made of metal. I mean, this is the patra bolte in usko, right? So, hum log usko squeeze karte karte nikala pata tha. Plus, of course, he must be knowing because I didn't. Right? It was very hard. At times, it was punctured as well. And it used to cut also many times. After that, maybe I was around 8 years or something, when we started having the advertisement saying, soft tube. And all those things. The Colgate with the soft tube. That advertisement started coming in, right? That means the tube are no more hard, no more pokey. They are soft. You can just press it and leave. You might extract the entire paste out of those tubes. Because the metal one, you could not really take the entire one. My papa has to press it and all those things, then it comes out. All those things. Right? It's better, right? Okay. This is one thing which you actually can understand that well. In adding a new segment of a car, right? because they want to have a little better experience in the luxury market or something. Adding instead of 2G, 3G and 4G. This is what you said, packaging. Right? And rupees 5 is not rupees 2. Right? And who did understand that? I mean, this is something that you can tell me. We get, in essence, like this, we get a pack of 8 biscuits, small biscuits, of course, global biscuits, for 2 rupees. Right? Just imagine, this is completely out of this, but of course, it might add to innovation as well. 8 biscuits with a wrap, it is to the retailer, that means it is transported by somebody, it is stocked by somebody, it is manufactured by somebody, paying salary for those people who are working in that, and they are definitely earning a huge out of it. And they have been sold for 2 rupees. So what do you mean by that? One biscuit manufacturing cost will be up to paise. Possibly, right? Then only they can have huge margin, the transport, the stock here, the transport here, the retailers earning their own profit, commissions, and we consume it for 2 rupees. 8 biscuits for 2 rupees. Great, man. I don't know what is the manufacturing cost of those rupees. I'm still thinking. This is long. Okay. So that is also a new way of adding, because earlier we used to have big packs. We might not consume that every time immediately, and those biscuits would go soggy. Next time you won't feel like eating. So that is where you are giving an existing product with a better packaging or better way of utilizing it. Right? Second level is where we are saying expanding from the existing business into the new company business requirements. The first was existing, just better experience. Second is, you are going to the new place where currently my business is not there. Right? Any idea? Any example? Where earlier it was not, now that the existing company went into the new area also.
Electric cars.
Okay? You said something.
Bata.
Yes.
Actually,
they're into footwear.
Yes.
Now they're into?
They're into footwear only, sir, but expanded new geographical area.
Okay. That, I think, which is actually a good word. Example. Who gave me that? Electric car. You. Good. Right. Any other example? Yes.
We are.
You didn't show it.
We are.
Sorry.
Huh?
Now they're into
media.
We are.
Yes.
Is it?
Yes.
Vijay.
Yes.
Oh, you need to show it. Any
Coke.
Coke. They're into.
Clothes.
Okay. Yes. Very much. So anything that currently it is existing in the market by others, not by my company. I ventured those areas. The best example to me is Patanjali. Right? Okay, I currently drive Hyundai. I really love that. Hyundai gets like, I think, 9-year-old car, but still it is giving me awesome performance. I don't want to sell it unless Patanjali launches one. And Dan James would do car launch one, sorry. Right? So he is the one who is absolutely innovative in this space too. Alright? So examples are, could be many. Android version of phone, Apple, Colgate, going into packaging foods, and Botox has been managed as a product, cosmetic product, right? Many companies, IT companies like earlier Wipro. Wipro started as, any idea what is Wipro? Any idea how did Wipro start with?
Vanaspati
food, yeah, Mr. Vanaspati oil. He started with an oil industry. Oil industry, oil business. He used to grind something, take some oil out and sell it off. And he is now into everything. He is into Ego laptops, he is into products, he is into services, into manufacturing. He has so many cosmetics, etc. People keep on venturing the other areas of business which are already existing. Now obviously the third one would be the areas which doesn't exist as of now. the area that doesn't exist as of now, I am actually creating that area and getting into that. Right? Area examples. Something that happened, created an area which actually did not exist. That absolutely is called disruption. Market disruption actually goes into this way.
Charging point,
that actually is in, that's actually in, I think it's in the second. Right? There is not a new area of business. Right? Getting my point? Yes, any new area of business that the people are avoiding. Market disruption we are talking about is the third area. Let me take you there. Right? I don't think we can live without WhatsApp. How many of you do not have WhatsApp accounts? Please don't raise hands. They don't get people to know. We don't have it. Good. Good job. Right. Because I don't think I can survive without WhatsApp. Right? I can. I mean, I check it once every day, twice, I would say. Lunchtime and dinner. Lunch goes with WhatsApp. Dinner goes with WhatsApp. The rest of the time, we don't have time for. But yes, I do have WhatsApp. And I do communicate with WhatsApp a lot of times. Right? And I make sure that if I miss it today, at least tomorrow I will read those messages. Facebook, Twitter. I don't really am active. I'm not really active on Twitter though. But all these social media, today we are talking about, can you live without it and can you not live without it? Right? To that extent, it has integrated in our lifestyle. Right? We would have asked you, can you stay without food or not? Which is a legitimate, I mean, obvious, valid question. Now we ask, can you live without it? Without Facebook and all these things. It is a new area that people have introduced and people fall prey to it. To such an extent that people are okay for not having a sandwich for 2 days, but no WhatsApp to eat. Right? So, other than that, what? How many of you have seen 3D printing? 3D printing. You see, go for Google. It will show you how to do the 3D printing. Right? It actually shows off what exactly 3D printing all about. Right? Because I was not amazing, it was mesmerizing when I saw it for the first time. Almost 2 years back. Right? One valid question that he was asking me when we were having an awesome, tasty tea. Just not behind. Right? He asked me, how is the market for the IT engineers today? Could be IT engineers or any of the market. How is it today in the market? I mean, it was so parenting question. I mean, so full of concern. Because he's concerned of his students. It's his children. So he was asking about that. I mean, I really doubt the question the way he asked. The answer that I gave was those who have multiple skills. Guys, I wanted to extend this answer to you. Because guys, with one skill, we might not stay long in the industry. People are asking for multiple skills. If I have this, you should have this also. Right? You have excellent project management skills. You have maybe MS project also, you know, maybe. Is it sufficient? You need to know data analytics. Because for managing something, if at all you are aware of what is happening since last 3 years, which as a basis I am going to create a new plan for my business or for my project, you need to know the previous data. Once you have big data, you need to know how to analyze that. You need to know how to use the data. Because data, unless you understand that, it's just a number. You hardly understand that. Unless you analyze that, you won't take a report out of it. Unless you take a report out of it, you won't understand what exactly the data is talked about. Once you understand the report, once you make any sense of the data, you can plan things for your project. Right? But you say, sir, but I know MS project very well. Can you have somebody for data analytics and he can give me the report, I can make a plan. He will say, Sunita, you do one thing. Take a sabbatical. Your name?
Pooja.
Pooja. I have Pooja who knows analytics also. Pooja, you take care. That's it. It's not in person again. Okay. Got it? Alright? So, unless you have multiple things that is sufficing, I said got it. Unless you have multiple things which suffices your role, you're not able to sustain in the industry. Right? Why did I come to that? Is this. Right? Cloud computing. Computing is, everybody knows, cloud computing is something that is actually disrupting the market. Now there is no more physical hardware data center and all those things. We are migrating it. Right? We are talking about data centers. I'm not sure if you are aware of that, what exactly that means. They are now legacy. Right? So this is a big thing when we are migrating from something stationary to cloud. There is nothing stationary in the laptops. Whenever what I am doing, just having a connection is required. That's it. And everything is somewhere virtual. We don't know where exactly it is. When I'm putting out this PPT, I know where exactly it is here. It is in this hard disk. Whenever I take this, that goes there. This goes off, my PPT goes off. Unless I have stored it in the cloud, I can take it down wherever, may it be in Hubli or Honolulu. Right? Nanotechnology is also one of those where we have disrupted things. 70, 20 and 10 is the current R&D spend. People are spending more on this existing area, little less on others are playing it, how can we enter in this? Very few people are looking into this. You can be one to be taken as a cream, not because of the marks, but because of your ability to think about it when you fall in this. It's not only about R&D. R&D will not do anything other than unless you tell them, do this and get clear with this. You ideally should fall in this. Right? Right? And that is the thing, but think, how can I do things differently? What else I can add things to? Right? One of those sales seminars, marketing seminars, I would say, that I was taking, I just gave an example of who is the best salesman. Right? A salesman, if he is selling you a beautiful pair of clothes or maybe a fantastic bucket range in the festival season, he's just an okay, good salesman. Salesman is a real salesman who can sell a refrigerator to the Eskimo in Kashmir. He should be able to sell a refrigerator there in the winters. He is the actual salesman because he has got power not in the product, it is the way he convinces. Right? That is one. What he actually did is, he actually tapped a market which possibly not exist. In Kashmir, the winter refrigerator doesn't require to be had. AC in the refrigerators, we don't need to do that. But we actually can do that if the salesman is there in that place. It's not only the salesman, it's the person who can go and see what is not there, what I can add. Create those clubs and do it. Right? The market discussion has already happened. How many of you know Uber? Good. How many cars do Uber own? I know the exact number.
Not one.
I know the exact number. Zero. Uber doesn't know why, which car to buy even. He knows how to manage fleet of cars. Right? The old, maybe it was in 2005, when I moved to Bangalore, we had four or five taxi services. They had a fleet of taxis with them. They had hired the drivers. They used to pay salaries to them. They used to have a call center. Guy would pick the call saying, yes sir, where do you want to go from where? Haan, Santosh, go to Bangalore. And this guy, Santosh, the driver, one of these cars will take there. He had 50 cars. The other guy was computed, he had 70 cars. That was the market. Uber came in saying, guys, you are absolutely fool. I don't have any car. Compete with me. That is market search. People get into those things is what matters. The area where you need to get into that. Hey, this is what. Innovation for its own sake is useless. Innovation that starts with insights about customer needs are the most likely to create economic value. Innovation when it comes to your perspective. Right? The very profound sentence. When it comes to your perspective, try to understand what does the customer need. Customer might not explicitly say that I need this. Customer might not say that because he doesn't know that he needs it. You need to think, oh my god, if what I give this to him, he will actually be not only happy, he will be adapted to it to the great extent that he will not be able to live without it. add those things. Collaboration actually was a need. Collaboration, you understand collaboration, right? Collaboration was actually a need. When Wikipedia came in, how many of you use Wikipedia? Almost everybody, right? Wikipedia came in as a solution for collaboration, where whatever you wanted to say about one topic, you type in there. There was a moderator, he would just go to that. There's a thing obscene and all those things, he would create a clean paper of it and he would post. He would allow the post to go in. And other people will read that and he'll get to know the information. People across the world could go get that. That was the basis of collaboration. Collaboration now is so widespread. Facebook and WhatsApp and all those things are different collaboration.
Oh, this is what? Uber, largest accommodation provider, Airbnb, doesn't have any hotel for himself. Phone companies, Skype and WeChat, they don't have any telephone infrastructure for themselves. Alibaba, he doesn't have any store for himself. Facebook, it doesn't have any content. Society money doesn't have any money. Netflix, he doesn't have any theater for himself. Apple and Google, they do not create any apps. People have been creating apps. Many things. Okay, guys.
There could be many ways to be creative. Right? I will just go through that once. But before that, I just wanted to have a quick 5-minute video. Talks about something called Scamper. Right? That is a way you can be, that is one of those ways you can be irrelevant. Right? Let us see what exactly that means. You can use this, apply this particular principle wherever you want.
big, minimized.
Right?
Okay, I think we are closing it. Okay, there are 20 solutions.
Good.
There are 20 solutions. These are the solutions that was given by students in the QA. Right? So when I don't have time, I don't have time to complete my work. My time is going off and I don't have time to complete my work. What should I do? Because you are going to delegate your work to somebody else. So delegate was one. They should hire more people so that they can work with you. So there could be repetitive things here, but these are those solutions that people like you gave maybe in the previous sessions that we had. So one is delegate. You understand delegation, right? Guys, delegation is an art. We have another one wellness session for delegation. Right? Hire staff. Remove the activities or tasks which is not required. Get help from others, as I was talking about, right? Rather than me reinventing the wheel, get it from somebody who actually has done already. Right? Get up at 5 a.m. Really good solution, because we tend to get up around 7:30 because we had to go to office again. Right? So get up at 5 a.m. you can finish your work. Okay, that was too much. Sleep for 4 hours only in the night. Okay, you take 1.5 hours for lunch break. You are allowed to take only 20 minutes. So stick to that. I spent almost 1.5 hours, and not about me, currently. I just stayed 10 kilometers away from my office. Right, in Bangalore, just nothing. Actually, very close is what called 10 kilometers. And I take 1.5 hours to commit one day. Right? And I don't have that flying car as of now. So I have to go on the road. Potholes and all those things are filled in there. So I know each and every measurement of every pothole there. That much is what we have to go through. And it takes 1.5 hours to go. A little more to come back because everybody comes at the same time. Right? So what I'm wasting is 3 hours a day. So it changed the time to start having more work. Reduce the personal times, buy a faster car. I don't know. Get a personal assistant, yeah. Personal driver so that you can work in the car. Getting salary for that first. Get a cleaner at home, okay? You have to clean first and then start for office? Okay, better you get a maid. Okay, unavailable. Go from home. Invite a colleague to home rather than going to office to have meetings. Move closer to office, buy an apartment flat to office, and all those things. And okay, learn to save. Guys, there's a book called Learn to Save. And this is a big book. So there's not only one sentence, it means a lot. I wish you can go through all that because I say, right? It is not being arrogant to say no. Right? I'm not telling you to be arrogant to say no. There's a technique to say no. Right? When, how, why you should say no. So those are those examples that we can say. Six thinking hacks is where I don't want to really take a long for that. This is also a book. You can be optimistic, rational, skeptical, creative, and pragmatic. I forgot that. So that's one. Okay, this is a classic example, and we are closing it here. This is a classic example of what is this? An MRI scanning machine, right? This is used for elders as well as children as well. If something happens, something not so good happens to children, they take there also. And just imagine, I tell the child, say, you have to lie here, this will go up and this will get in there. Your head will go inside here. Will the child be able to go? When he's awake and say, okay, I want to go there. Will he really enjoy going there? No. The same thing you keep in the park, play area and all those things, they are happy to go there and come out. Not here. Right? So what is that you need to do? She's talking to the child, doesn't really follow. So what did they do? They did this. Right? Is it innovative? Is it creative? Is it adding value? Right? The work out of that machine, did it change? Did the output of this machine change? No. Did the input of the machine change? Absolutely yes. Right? Because the number of children who go inside is definitely more. Because otherwise children won't go there. Right? So that can be a part of being innovative in terms of having value added, though it is not always a business value. Or it's not always a monetary value.
it adds value to the person as a human being. Right? Here, the person is being sensitive. The person is talking about the child's psychology. For that, you need to be really sensitive. For that, you need to be really refined from within. Right? Because unless I step in your shoes, I won't be able to understand what exactly you are going through. Just like that, I have to step in your shoes to get to know that you are getting bored. Right? So, be that. Be sensitive. Be empathetic. Right? This is one more. I think the last slide for this. Right? This is a MITI fridge. And MITI cool is a fridge where most of us know about. Right? So, just continuing the point that we spoke. For all these things, there's something called design thinking. Have you heard of that? Design thinking, have you heard of this? Go ahead, make a Google search or a YouTube search. It will talk about design thinking. Think through the customer's perspective. Think through the other person's perspective. That is not easy. That is not possible unless you are clean here, you are refined here, you are balanced here, and you are actually composed. That is not easy in this world. In the competitive world that you have to step in, or even now, it's not that easy. You are so distracted. We are so distracted. It's not that easy to think anything other than us, me and my world, nothing else we currently see. Start thinking about others. Have your horizon widened. Have everybody here. And then you get to know what is it that this person needs. Innovation comes like this. Creativity comes like this. It's not always the tools. It is the medium that gives you creativity. Refine this. Have control, have balanced. Make sure you maintain it. Alright? Okay, I am done for the session so far. If at all you have any questions, please go. Right? I hope you enjoyed, not sure. But yeah, a lot to go over. But all the best to all of you. And if at all you have any questions, I'm there for you. Yes?
Is required for MBA students?
No, it is required for everybody who would want to succeed in a different way. MBA students, just to pass the exam and all those things, I'm not talking about. When I'm saying MBA students, because it is you, when you go to the market, when you go to the society, when you go to the environment where you have to be competitive, being competitive is not enough. Being innovative is required. And you can't always keep on stressing yourself a lot. Rather than that, you can work smartly, you can work innovatively, you can work creatively. So that's what I said. Thank you. Hey, you deserve a chocolate because you are the only one who asked the question. He goes. Because you need, you give the chocolates. Okay. Alright, thank you very much. I'm done so far. Because you